Hey guys, my name's Joseph.
And I'm Jans.
And we're going to be showing off our latest project we've built in Minecraft, a working vending machine. Now, this was a project we've built today. It is actually a real working vending machine in the game Minecraft. So, as we enter the machine, we walk up these stairs, and here we see we have the options that you would see on a normal vending machine. We have the payment slot, so basically the payment in this machine is 5 diamonds. All of the items cost 5 diamonds. The pay button, and these are the actual choices of things you want to buy. So the machine currently has cake, cookies, glistering melons, and the refund button. I'll show you that later, but you can choose any one of these 3 options. So what we need to do, we need to drop 5 diamonds onto this diamond block. So I've put down 5 diamonds. And I simply click the pay button. Now, as I click pay, the thing seals up and the processing payment lights up, and then the money is received and it says please buy an item. So these lights all turn on, and now we are ready to make a purchase. So I'm going to choose a cake, and we click the button, and we look at the purchase collection slot. Right now, a cake is purchased. Yeah, so right now it's also got an interesting feature. It's got the invalid items or change slot. So basically, let's say I were to put in 7 diamonds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and also some redstone accidentally, and you click the pay button, the machine's going to seal up and it's going to process the payment just fine. Everything's going to go fine, but what's actually going to happen? The invalid items change menu is going to light up, and we wait a while, and all of those items, that those 2 diamonds and those 2 redstone, is going to drop down. So these are the same items that we had earlier, and it's all going to work just fine. So right now you see I've picked up 2 diamonds and 2 redstone, and of course it has still saved the payment that we had earlier, so I can go and make another payment. Now I'm going to show you refund option. You just click refund and it will give you back 5 diamonds. So this is pretty much the main functionality of the actual machine. Now we're going to go into the management section of the machine. Jans is going to be showing you this section.
Okay, so you've probably been wondering where all the diamonds go. As we were walking up the stairway, you probably saw this is the management door that leads to the management area. It has a key. Right now it uses a key. The key is a fire charge. There isn't any other key that will work at this moment. Press the button. You heard a lot of pistons and the door opens. In here there's a button that'll just close and open the door, whatever. Okay, so you go down this suspiciously long hallway. And welcome to the management area. So here we have the profit machine. It's basically where you throw in the diamonds. 5 diamonds will come through this machine. As you can see, there's 20 in it because we've done like 4 purchases already. Just take out the diamonds quickly. And you can just could put it inside this chest. The refund, basically it's just a dispenser that dispenses 5 diamonds, and there isn't really, it's not gonna refill itself. It could probably make it refill itself, but right now it's not automatic, it's manual. So put in some diamonds and press refund. Refills the refund and it'll come back. And also these lights that you see here, turn around, those will go on whenever a purchase is made. So I'm just going to make a purchase. You just stay here.
Jans is going to make a purchase quickly. You will see the lights turn on and this minecart is going to go and take the diamonds, and it will return back in a few seconds. So Jans is now going to make the purchase, and he is making the purchase.
Okay, there you go. So basically, it doesn't as soon as you put in the diamonds, it's like it's yours. Because the refund, it comes through a separate dispenser. So it's not like you legitimately get your diamonds back. So that is pretty much it for your management section.
Yeah, that pretty much concludes the actual demonstration of the device and the management. Now we're going to go on to the behind the scenes of how this machine actually works. Okay, now we're going to be showing you the behind the scenes of this project. As you can now see, the machine is a lot more complex than it actually looked from the inside. Yes, it is actually very confusing with us, even looking at it, what certain things do, like just looking at a wire at a glance.
I mean, yeah, you wouldn't know where it's coming from unless you actually trace it back to the buttons.
Yeah, this machine is really, we haven't labeled anything. It's, really difficult to even understand what's going on. But first of all, I'm going to start at the insert five diamonds part of the project. This is pretty much, okay. I'm going to do this in logical order just to make it as understandable as possible. Okay, right now, you can put in the diamonds.
Diamonds, you just go outside.
So, I'm going to go below this part. There is actually a piston that covers up the diamond block. So there's a piston that covers up the diamond block over here. So that diamond block is covered by the stream. Then when the diamond block is released or moved away, the items drop underneath. Then the diamonds are going to fall into this hopper. So as they fall into this hopper, the cart is going to come and pick up the diamonds, and then these diamonds are going to drop down into this cart. So the cart comes here, then the cart goes back up, and this is the manager's office place, and then it's dispensed back. So what happens right now, the hopper for this side is actually almost full. It's got 59 items. It's full in every slot, but it needs 5 more items in the slot. So what I'm doing, I'm using a comparator and actually connected to as the output to read how full it is. Now I am one, the redstone is almost completely full, but there's only one left. So when the thing is filled completely with 5 redstone, it triggers the last signal, all 15 blocks, which then triggers a mechanism for actually calling the cart to come and take all of, or to take the 5 items out. And it's timed specifically for the cart to actually come and pick up exactly 5 blocks and then go back once it's reached its limit to no longer be at the last block update, or no longer be at the last block, then it just goes back. Then once this cart goes back, it actually drops its items into these hoppers. These hoppers just go down, and when this hopper has any items, it only works for 1 block, which means if there's any items in here, I'm going to do this for example, I'll put in a random item. It's going to call the cart from the manager's office, put the item in the cart, and go back upstairs. So that's sort of the cart part of this project. And right now it's just getting more and more items. So now I'm going to actually show you more mechanisms. So for example, when you press the pay button, it does more than just opens up the basic, it doesn't just move away the diamond block. First of all, I'm going to show you the different checks in this system. When you click the pay button, the processing payment latch is open. So basically it's just a toggle latch that opens up. So right now it's opened, and it's got a timer that takes a while to actually close it and turn it off. So during the time that processing payment is taking place, a sand door is sealed to close it up, so you can't actually do anything right now, it's closed. And if you actually put diamonds inside the machine, I've put in the 5 diamonds, and if it has money received, then it actually keeps the door closed. The reason this happens is because when money is received, you don't actually want to go and pay more, because then you end up losing out the money. So here we've just actually purchased an item. Okay, so I'll explain what happens when you actually purchase an item. Here I've got a blistering melon. If I follow this trace, it actually goes through an AND gate. Now the first input on the AND gate is the actual button. Basically an AND gate in logic is when you have both inputs are turned on. Only when both inputs are on, then the output is on. If one input is on, then the output's off. If the other input's on, then the output's still off, only if both are on. So the first input is a button, the second input is the indicator light for the money received. Yeah, so when this lamp is turned on and the glistering melons button's pressed, it's going to dispense the item. As you can see, the light is off, so pressing any of these buttons, they're all linked up to AND gates, they just won't work, they'll do nothing. So if I follow the output of the AND gate, the output is going to go to these dispensers that will dispense the different items. Here we have the droppers for glistering melons, cookies, cakes, and the dropper for the diamonds.
The refunds.
Yeah, for the refunds. So these on the other side, they're not being used at the moment. We might add more at a later stage.
And also, I just want to add, under this water stream is ice, and apparently water over ice makes it flow even faster. So that's like why all the items appear really fast after you press the buy button.
Yes, ice works as an accelerator. So the other output of the AND gate goes to the... It actually goes to another AND gate. And what this other AND gate does, it is also connected up to... Oh, wait, yeah. This also goes to the other AND gate, which is connected up to the second button, and it's also connected up to the third AND gate, which is connected to the third button. So basically, when you press any of these buttons, it's going to... This input that's connected to all three, it's going to be turning off the money received light. So whenever you press one of these buttons, it turns off the light, which means you can't make another purchase unless you press the buy button and trigger the mechanism again. So this is just a, you could say, a security feature, but it's pretty standard. You can't do anything without that. And then also, how does the invalid items and change button work? Well, basically, as you'll notice, any items that pass over the dropper, the dropper can only fit 5 more items. So if you put more than 5, it will only suck in diamonds because there's only slots for diamonds available. It's only going to suck in diamonds. Any other items that are not sucked in will go to this hopper, and these hoppers just go in a path. As you can see, Jan's put in some random stuff. The other items go through these droppers, and they're all sucked over here. Then this cart comes down from below. It comes and takes in the items, and once it's full, it goes back up and gets this dispenser. This dispenser then drops off all of the items down below. So this mechanism is actually very slow because you have to wait, first of all, for the items to reach the end of the water stream. I can make it more efficient. I just kept them far apart for testing and stuff, and it also takes a while for the items to pass between the droppers until it reaches its destination. You also have to wait for the cart to arrive, so it is a fairly inefficient system, but it works reliably, which is pretty good. And yeah, we've just built this right now, so otherwise the system is actually fairly robust. Things like, well, it's impossible right now to actually, pretty much once you've put some diamonds in and you click pay, a sand door closes up completely, which means you cannot do anything unless it's paid. So I'll show you the sand door. It's a pretty standard sand door. It has two pistons, a piston that pushes a piston, and then when you turn on and off the mechanism, the timing is set up to actually release both pistons. So you get a 2-block-high door, and then the sand just falls due to gravity. And the pay button is completely disabled. I'll show you why. Because the pay button is actually linked up to an AND gate. Now the AND gate is actually connected to the sand door. So if the sand door is open, i.e. the signal is on, which means open, and the button's pressed, then it's gonna run the normal mechanism. But if the sand door is closed, the sand door closed as an on signal, I just invert it to off, then nothing's going to happen. Absolutely nothing will happen. The diamond block piston won't open, the door won't move, and yeah, nothing's going to happen. So right now, the only thing you can do right now is click refund or buy an item. So when I click refund, the refund AND gate's going to toggle, and we have another mechanism that will produce 5 signals for the repeater. So this repeater is going to pulse 5 times, and this is just a timer circuit that Jan's built to actually just post 5 times.
It took a long time to really set it exactly the right time. Now it takes for to post exactly 5 times.
Yeah, that was one of the, it took a while.
Really long.
Yeah. And here's the other cart, which is for refilling the refunds chest.
Refilling the refund.
Yeah, refilling the refund. So basically, you fill up that chest, then the chest moves along.
It looks exactly the same with the other
cart. Yeah, it moves along this track, reaches the top, which is actually where the dispenser is for the diamonds refunds. So it literally just goes above this hopper, then it detects until the cart is empty. It will stay here until the cart empties, and when the cart is completely empty, it will send the cart back. So the cart's going to stay there until it's empty, then it will just be sent back to the original starting point. And here are the toggle latches and things for the doors. Here's the toggle latch for the door lock.
Security door.
Yeah, for the security door. It actually uses a block update caused by the fire charge when it hits the piston and updates, which then causes the door to toggle. And it's actually a very interesting system that Jantz made. I actually haven't heard of that design before. These things, it's just the toggle for the lamp. This is just the lamp for the change and invalid items. It's also connected to a note block, so if I just go and cut the wire to this thing, the note block is just gonna play a sound. And there's also note blocks on the roof. These note blocks will play a tune when the payment is being processed, i.e. when this light turns on.
It's being processed.
Yeah, processing payment, and I'll just...
Yeah.
If I put in some diamonds, you can hear it.
And then there's like a really high note that symbolizes that the payment has been made.
Yeah. It's over here. So, I mean, pretty much everything, all of the main mechanisms that we've used, we've mentioned now. So, this project, when you think about it, I'm going to build a vending machine in Minecraft, it actually seems fairly simple, but when it actually comes to putting it together, there's a lot more aspects to this project that you wouldn't originally think about. Here's one thing we had to do for the processing payment button, because the processing payment light turns on in a latch, and it will only turn off when the money received light turns on. But this will only turn on if it receives the correct currency. So let's say it's already got, I'm just going to get a refund right now. Let's say I were to put in 4 diamonds. If I only put in 4, nothing's going to happen. It's going to close, but it's going to hang forever. So we've got actually a timer set up to manually cancel the latch and reopen it after a few seconds, just because nothing's happened. And you'll see in the hopper over here, for the payment in this hopper, it has got 63 items. It needs one more diamond. So after that transaction is completed, all I need to do is just put in one more diamond, and the transaction will complete successfully, and then I can go and get another refund. So currently there's no way of actually getting change. If you put in extra blocks, or if you put in 2 little diamonds, let's say 3 diamonds, you can't get it back. And currently I'm trying to think of a way to do this, but I have a few ideas, but we'll still need to implement it. Okay, so this has been a project we've been working on.
How long did it take?
Well, we've been working on it pretty much the whole day. I'd say
It's a whole day.
Okay, so this has been an interesting project. I'm glad we're finally done with it, and the results have been really cool. We'll provide a download to the map if you want it. Just ask us. We'll probably actually post it in the video description.
Really?
Yeah, we'll just post it in the description. So yeah, just please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and give some feedback. Any ideas you'd like to see, or any questions, just ask us in the comment section. Okay, thanks for watching.
Cheers.
Yeah, okay, goodbye.